Hello everyone, a hearty welcome to Naipunya Vikasam channel. I am V.V. Sai Lakshmi from Y.N. Pakal, GTWA school, Y.N. Pakal, Koyuru Mandal, Visakha district. Today start off on a good topic. Today I am going to deal with life skills topic, self and personal introduction. A self introduction explains who you are, what you do, and what others need to know about you. You should provide a self-introduction anytime you meet someone new when you don't have a third person to introduce you. Personal introduction is a chance to highlight your skills, experience, education, and career interests to someone new. Introducing yourself is much more than saying your name. A self-introduction is the way the person introduces himself to others, gives a good impression on him. So, introduction always must be in a perfect manner. When you introduce yourself to others, it gives an impression that you are in a perfect manner to introduce yourself without any fear. So, for example, when you move from your home place to some other place, so you would like to mingle with the other persons, or you would like to join with them. So, first of all, you would like to introduce yourself, then you have a chance to prove yourself when you introduce you in a perfect manner. When you are introducing yourself in a group of people, you would like to address in a such a way that by saying, "Good morning everyone." First of all, thanks for giving me this opportunity to introduce myself. When you meet an important person in a company or in an office, you have to introduce in a such a way that you have to say that I have decided to write this email to introduce myself. Due to some company reorganizations, I would like to inform you that your account is now managed by me. My name is so-and-so and I am responsible for your account. Anytime you need anything related to sales, you can email directly to your mail address. This is introduction between two persons when they meet in a business purpose. There are some tips for introducing yourself at a job interview. First of all, when you face an interview, tell the interviewer that it is a pleasure to meet them. The meeting must be in a such a way that you have to have a good smile on your face and a good eye contact with the other person. Keep your introduction short and concise. Focus on your qualification. Be prepared to follow up questions. These are few points to remember in an introduction when you're facing an interview. Start introduction with a smile on your face, giving details about your name, place after greetings. If necessary, only add your family details. Tell about your educational qualifications. Share about why you don't want to do job or you're willing to do such a job. And then explain about the project which you are dealing or which you are going to be given. and the person who inspired you a lot to join in a particular job or a project. In a self-introduction, children, both your words and body language makes an impact on first impressions. Controlling your body language is essential to saying poised and professional in a new introduction. When you approach a new coworker in your department, start with a strong handshake and maintain eye contact during the conversation. When you introduce yourself to someone, you can demonstrate confidence by speaking in a clear and audible voice. During your conversation, maintain natural body language with relaxed shoulders and open arms by your side. A self-introduction is always an important one to make a good impression on ourselves. So, introduction always must be in a perfect manner. When you are asked in a class to introduce yourself, you have to start with your name, next, your studies, your family details, the things which you like most, everything can be added in your self-introduction. Self-introduction always makes a good impression about ourselves to others. So, I hope everyone enjoyed this class. Thank you. Have a nice day.